in our countries, the education is underrated. How can we apply this example? What are the critical points of this case?
I think that we can learn what we can get from these two parts that they at the beginning when you were like in the prehistoric case that they had hands on the material and so they can experience that they are using the basic things or whether it's technology for them. So in that way they are learning from experience, and that is something that is really useful for students. So for every single kind of student, when they have hands on, they're learning it's a lot more significant than when you're just right in front of a board, for example. They are not experiencing everything. And memorizing is not something that is a lot easy when you are just right in front of a board or a screen or whatever. So when you have hands on the learning process, it's when you have something that you are going to learn in that moment, and then you are going to internalize in yourself and you can use it for future experiences. So whether it's for themselves or for teaching their students.
You are thinking.
Yeah.
Oh, what?
So we have, I feel pretty bad because we have to teach students how to do things. Yeah, not just to... Yeah. Have to... Not just to listen,
okay.
But to, I think the most important thing is that they do things.
Mm-hmm.
They apply for us.
How was the learning process in that age?
Through experience.
Trial.
Very practical.
Very practical.
There is no another way because if we are there.
It has worked.
Yes.
There were no teachers.
Okay.
Yeah.
And that is my critical point. We need to survive. Our questions. What is our main objective when we design or teach the course?
That they learn and they put in practice what they have learned. We need to do an analysis.
This is useful, it's meaningful.
Okay.
It is when they're going to use it. That's
and it's necessary to analyze the results. Put into practice, definitely, in everyday situations.
Mm-hmm. Trial and error situation.
Yeah.
And what is our greatest difficulty?
We have mixed ability classes. Yeah, heterogeneous classes are a little bit difficult. You can have a beginner student, and you can have an advanced student. So you have to adapt the material,
class,
definitely.
Well,
yeah. In the same class. Both beginners and really advanced beginners.
Well, why?
Hi.
Why?
Why? Well, because we receive, a variety of students, definitely, and from different nationalities and from different kind of backgrounds, private schools, to not public schools, so definitely it's a little bit difficult, and for different ages, too.
And they learn different, too. They learn
of course. They are kinesthetic, visual, you know.
One of them can be visual, but the other
auditory,
so they're going to be bored in the classes because they were expecting more, maybe.
And how can we do that better?
I think that if we want to insert technology, we have to teach them how to deal with technology. Because it's not only that they are going to use the WhatsApp or YouTube, no, they have to deal how to prepare or how to write a forum, how to upload a forum, how to comment a forum. So we have to just know that they must know at least the minimum requirements to take an online course.
But then I think that depends on the type of student, because nowadays
use this program, this platform, and then you can use whatever you want, WhatsApp, whatever, YouTube, Google. But I think that we need our spaces, okay? For example, in France, okay, you just enter and you just give your cell phone, okay? And that could be a good alternative for me, okay? And you are going to just have your cell phone back when the class finishes. It depends. It depends on the kind of student. So we have different points of view, but.
What do you think that the technology could be?
It could
like
be
an obstacle or a tool.
It depends on how you use it.
We are all here
yeah.
adults.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, what about the sex? Sex with technology or sex like sex always me? What's your opinion? Are you agree with this? Instructional design is the systematic development of instructional specification using learning and instructional theory to ensure the quality of instructional level. Is this okay? Or you have another idea? Or this could be a good start? My concept, tools,
mm-hmm.
only tools, and the tools could change, always. We build together asking questions. First, we need to explore instructional design models and the progression of the learning design approach to creating online learning experiences. Thinking of people, what is the typical background of the student participant who will undergo the program? That's your point. Subject and taking a look at what needs to be developed and improved. Review of existing personal strategies employed. Are they adequate? Or we can personalize? Can we create something new? What do the students need to accomplish at the end of the program? What are the learners' needs? In the case of English, what do we need? I need to improve my English, personally. So maybe the texts are adequate. What is the better method? What is your opinion?
I mean that students must be
help instructors to create materials and provide guidance for the best practice in online teaching. Learn how to create online courses that work efficiently by understanding how people learn and how to design the experience. We need an experience.
I was thinking about the name distant learning. I don't know if the term is okay. Distant learning. Distant. I think that this word broke.
We are taught classes online.
Online. We need an effective and engaging learning experience. So blended or hybrid learning environment. Synchronous and asynchronous with a variety of media, video, audio, along with accessibility. And of course, the always on online course. They redesigned this.
Professor, I'm here at San Ignacio College. Are you using synchronous or asynchronous methodology? You're using both.
That's a balance.
But I think that right now, in all the work, we are in an experimenting phase.
Synchronous.
But this term of synchronous or asynchronous is not only in terms of time, it's also in terms of space.
Yes, because we need freedom. And the synchronous, with the synchronous learning system, we don't have freedom, but we need also discipline.
Mm-hmm. Of course. If you want to take a synchronous class, definitely you have to